AIM-listed oil and gas exploration company Petrel Resources has recently been awarded two new licensing options in the Porcupine Basin offshore Ireland. And today we welcome David Horgan, director at the company, to find out more about Petrel's strategy to develop these assets. Hello, David.
Hello.
Thank you very much for joining us today. So tell me, what's the strategy in acquiring these new licensing options?
Well, the Irish offshore has never been seriously explored. It's very large compared to the land territory. And until recent years, it wasn't possible to access most of it because it's Atlantic. You were limited to about 500 meters of water depth, and you were limited to certain months of the year. But with the advance of technology and the higher oil prices, averaging about $50 or so now, a lot of that acreage is now economic to explore. And we decided to be one of the first taking acreage, working it up, applying experiences from West Africa and elsewhere, as well as modern techniques like state-of-the-art 3D seismic, and hopefully attract in international partners to drill some wells.
You have spoken about the quality of your new acreage. What makes you say that? Can you say a few words about each of these licensing options?
Yeah, well, we already have two considerable frontier exploration licenses that are already partnered with Woodside Energy, and work is progressing very aggressively on those. So our strategy in this round was to target acreage in medium depth water between about 600 and 800 meters, so not super deep, close to existing discoveries to make it an easier sell, and with play types that had been neglected historically, particularly the Cretaceous West African type play that has never really been considered until recent years in the Irish offshore. And we focused on three priority areas, expecting to get maybe one or one and a half, and actually we got two of the three that we bid for.
So tell us about the work program you plan and how you will add value.
Well, there's quite a bit of seismic and other data already in our proprietary database that we've collected over the last 15 years. In addition, one of the large independents has acquired seismic over one of the blocks. So we hope to purchase the seismic that is currently available, reprocess it using state-of-the-art technology, all the lessons we've learned from working with Woodside, and reinterpret that data in the light of what's now being discovered, not just in the Irish waters, but also in the east of Canada waters, which was once joined geologically to Ireland. And a lot of new ideas about possible new discoveries are actually coming from eastern Canada, as well as West Africa. So the Atlantic margin is a rapidly evolving area of interest for explorers.
And how will you finance this program? Do you intend to work with partners?
Well, we've already got €1 million euro in the kitty, and that's more than enough to fund two or more work programs in these license options. We don't have almost any expense in the company at the moment because we're fully carried by Woodside on the Irish work, and will be for some years to come. And we're also carried on our activities in Iraq, although there hasn't been a lot of activity there recently. So effectively, we've got almost no expenses. So from current cash resources, we'll be able to fund. But we wouldn't be keen in this depressed environment to raise any more money, because we think that the carry that we have on our existing licenses alone is worth a multiple of our total market cap. So it would be irresponsible and stupid to dilute now when we think we will have much more value in the future.
Any farm-out interest? You've mentioned that talks were currently underway. Can you tell us a bit more about that?
The farm-out market is quite different to the oil market, and you would think it's quite depressed, and for most people it has been. But certain hotspots in the world are actually quite interested, and one of those is the Porcupine Basin. I think it would be a harder sell if you were in remote areas like Rock All or maybe the Celtic Sea to the south of Ireland. But the Porcupine, for a number of reasons, is right in the middle of a hotspot. Now, will you get as good a deal as you got 5 years ago? Probably not. But you will get a deal if you can pull together a good technical package. And our strategy has been, since 2011, to approach people in Houston and Calgary, and indeed London and Madrid and Paris, to keep our potential partners or past partners aware of what we're doing, and to bring them along in this process of work, not only to farm out to them in the future when we're ready and they're ready, but also to get their inputs to the ongoing course of the work. So while nothing is certain until you get the hot data and you can consummate the relationship, the indications so far are quite positive. It's become an easier sell now than it was in the years past.
And I'd like to know if you have any plans to expand your presence in the Porcupine Basin in the future, given that, using your own words, you've said that it's underexplored and has reserve potential.
Yes, we would have, and we're going to bid more aggressively on the southern part of the basin, but we heard that the supermajors were bidding aggressively. ExxonMobil, Nexen, which is owned by the Chinese CNOC, our friends Woodside, Statoil and others. So we made the decision not to put a lot of resources into bidding in this round. However, some of the international companies have learned the hard way that it's wise to have a local partner, by which we mean an Irish company rather than, say, just a European company, to smooth the ways with the local community and even with the authorities. And we're hopeful that in the years to come that we'll be able to negotiate on reasonable terms access to some of the acreage that has already been licensed.
Okay, David, so to wrap up, when we next hear from you, what is it likely to be about?
We'll be reporting on the seismic program that's underway this summer in our existing frontier exploration licenses, and we'll be updating people on the work that is starting very shortly on the new license options.
Okay, David, thank you very much.
Thank you.
David Horgan, Director at Petrel Resources.